This weather is just about impossible to dress for. I've been wearing my sweatshirt, too hot. I wear this and the breeze is just, feels ice cold. So I can either go down in this drainage here because I want to get over to that saddle because there's an arch over here that I want to get to. But I think I'm going to opt to walk around the high side, drop down and then get up to the saddle that way. This stuff here is biological soil crust, and it is a combination of lichen, moss, and cyanobacteria. And the cyanobacteria sort of creates these root-like structures, which not only hold the soil together, but give the moss and the lichen something to grow on. Cubic kilometers of earth has eroded away from the Colorado Plateau in the last 10 million years. It's just such an exercise to try to conceive of that. But I don't think there could be a better place to come and do exactly that. To say I'm blown away is an understatement. last 2 days, the moon and the sun have set and risen at the same time. Politely sharing the sky with one another. Almost to the minute, actually. It's kind of interesting. Absolutely glorious morning here. Just so grateful to be here. Have a few decisions to make. I only have this much water left, so it makes no sense to make my dehydrated breakfast. So I'm just gonna have lunch first and then my breakfast for lunch. And I'm gonna drop down into this valley over here, over this ridgeline, down towards the Paria River, and probably go upstream and then into another slot canyon where I hopefully can get up that slot canyon and up on a further ridge where I can cross that and into another canyon. So that's the plan for today. I'm sure there'll be some variation of that, not the actual plan, but the whole idea is just come out here and explore. There's no trails, which just really suits my style. I just love wandering and just so grateful to be here. It's pretty tricky trying to figure out how to get down this ridgeline. I've been cliffed out numerous times. As you can see, I'm trying to get down there. But I think if I kind of skirt along this way, I can make it down here and I can end up going out that way and then down. I'm just trying to keep it not sketchy, take my time. This will probably be the most harrowing part of the day. It's funny because I thought the hard part was over. This stuff can be nice to walk on, but when it's crusty on the top, you just kind of roll off of it, and it's capable of keeping a really steep embankment, as you can see right here. So I opted for the little scree chute, even though there's a danger of rock fall. This mud gravelly sort of thing, this stuff just, I don't understand, so I just stay clear of it. The rocks I get, the rocks I know. I just slipped here, just slid down into this. Probably have some scrapes on this out of my thigh, but other than that, no worse for wear. It's always when you drop your guard. It's funny, I was just in the process of thinking, almost there. Coyote just ran in front of me. Yeah, coyote just ran in front of me across the wash. looks exactly the same. I know this is gonna clog up my filter very quickly. I'm not quite sure what else to do in this situation. Somebody more adept at desert travel, please let me know. I'm sure I'm doing a bunch of things wrong, but honestly, it's been so wonderful traversing a brand new landscape in this manner. I'm learning so much. So appreciative for this experience. Sunset last night, the sunrise, the coyote that I just saw. I didn't get on film, but nonetheless. I just stashed my bag and packed a small little pack. I'm probably gonna camp back there at a sandbank because it's a lovely spot. But I'm gonna head up here and explore this canyon. Totally incredible. I was not expecting that. I'm just going up the other arm of this canyon right now. So much to explore, not enough time. I have a confession to make. I have a problem. I'm a slot canyon addict. I've had one hit and I'm addicted. I just keep on going and going, just looking for more. But I gotta turn around. Somebody help me, please. I gotta go back to camp though. After watching the stream for a little while, it's really apparent how dynamic it is. I mean, you can see it changing right before your eyes, just because there's so much sediment in it and how shallow it is. There's little standing waves over here just a few minutes ago, and now they're gone. And the current's kind of split into two. I don't think there's a body of water more dynamic than this. And it also brings me back to that whole idea that 300,000 cubic kilometers of Earth has eroded away from the Colorado Plateau in the last 10 million years. It's hard to conceive from a vista kind of looking at it, but when you come down here, right by the stream, and see how much material is moving, it becomes a little bit easier to comprehend.